Okay, back today talking about media intelligence, not to be confused with media monitoring. Media monitoring is simply counting numbers. Media intelligence is about dissecting the entire media ecosystem and all its parts to uncover defendable and actionable insights that you can make decisions from. Now, these type of insights can help you understand a lot of things. It'll help you understand how to get coverage in those high impact media publications that have no idea who you are. It'll help you understand why those high impact media publications are covering your competitors on the daily and not you. It'll help you understand how your narrative is being perceived by one media group versus another. And lastly, you can identify white space in the market in case you need to pivot your narrative and change your engagement strategy. So let's go ahead and take a look on how you might do this. So I call this the multi-channel media matrix, and it's broken down like this. Now on the left, you're gonna see brand and competitive mentions, and this will obviously be a priority for you as you track media relevancy, reputation, and other brand factors. And also, depending on the line of business you work in, you wanna track certain topics that describe the market and or the problems that you are trying to solve. Now, along the top, you have specific media channels. Now, I wanna spend some time talking about these because this is where you can start to see unique insights and coverage. Now, all business media is pretty self-explanatory. This is Forbes, Business Insider, Bloomberg, The Wall Street Journal, and all tech media outlets are pretty much the same as well. The Verge, TechCrunch, VentureBeat, Gizmodo, and ReadWrite. Now, I'm not going to get into financial media, not because it's not important, but because it's just something I'm not interested in. It's actually kind of boring to me. Okay, so here is where we start to get a little bit more focused. The top business media isn't necessarily the same thing as the all business media. There's certainly overlap, but the top business media are the highest priority publications that you care about. Maybe it's your top 10 or top 25 media outlets. And this is the same definition for the top tech media as well. Now, trade media, if you work in a security company, are publications like Dark Reading, Threat Post, and Security Week. And analyst coverage isn't really what you think it is. Well, it is, but it's a little bit more. Now, certainly if you're a software company and you have some cash, the Magic Quadrant is something you'll want to be included in because it garners coverage for days, years in many cases. But there's more. Now, most analyst firms are also media powerhouses, and they publish long-form content weekly and in some cases daily. Now, while they may not necessarily mention you specifically, but I guarantee you that they are going to be talking and writing about topics that you are going to want to pay attention to. LinkedIn blogs, huge. Thousands of blog posts are written on the platform every day about every business topic that you can think of. And the same thing for Medium. Last I looked, they were about 100 million unique visitors per month, and the content isn't just about technology and business. In fact, fashion, sports, healthcare, and even food are topics that dominate Medium headlines. So the next natural question you might have is, why would you spend so much time and resources measuring share of coverage for each of these individual channels? Well, first, I'm not going to tell you to measure share of coverage at all. I take that back. It might be a data point on a slide somewhere, but I'm going to tell you that you need to analyze the context and the narratives of each media channel, because I can guarantee you this, the way the business media covers your brand, your business, is different than the way tech media does. And when you decrease that data set from all to just the top business media and going from maybe 300 media publications to just about 10 or 25, your mind will be blown on how each channel contextualizes your brand, competitors, and even the topics that are important to you. Now, I have topics here because you need to be spending more time understanding how you can align your narrative to what's relevant in the marketplace. Now, if you recall a few months ago, I talked about the supply and demand of brand relevance, which is about understanding what stories and topics are demanding the attention of your audience. And in this case, it's the media. And then asking yourself if the content you are supplying to the market is meeting the demand of your audience. Now, you can only get this type of data from multi-channel media intelligence. Again, this is not media monitoring or even social listening. Now, this is where you're gonna find white space, because at the topic level, you can uncover unique insights when you segment the media, mine their coverage, cluster it into specific subtopics, and then contextualize the results. So here's a quick example. I did a very quick cursory scan of data and cross-referenced each of these specific media channels. And as you can see, the way each of these segmented channels cover data is different. Now, I'm not gonna go through each one because it's right here on the screen, but let me just highlight a few. Let's take the extremes. The business media is talking about using data to drive digital transformation. Very high-level business topic. And if you look at the top tech media, They're covering companies that are using data to track COVID-19 and how they're using AI to predict new cases. And then to call out one more, Medium, the conversation is revolving around decision-making and machine learning. Now, as you can see, when you segment the media and contextualize the coverage at that level, you can glean very specific and actionable insights that will help you make smarter decisions. And yes, you can measure share of voice and share of coverage at each of these channels. In fact, it'd be pretty interesting to see the variance of coverage between each. And that is why multi-channel media intelligence will crush all of your other PR metrics. And that concludes our time together. I hope that this video was as insightful for you to watch as it was for me to record. Please be safe. Please be healthy. Have a great week, and I'll see you next time.